Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our monthly update, where we drop some knowledge on you about all the different things that we updated inside of our application in the last month. Here's what we did in August of 2023. Let's jump right into it. First and foremost, we have Airtable Personal Access Token support. So this is actually something that we talked about in a previous video. Essentially what happened here was is that the Airtable API key is actually going away. So you'll notice that when you are able to create a new application here and I click Airtable, there are two options now. The API key was the original one. However, they're no longer allowing you to create new tokens. So not really something that we'd be able to do. So now what you're able to do is do the personal access token. The personal access token is essentially an alternative where you can create a new token, call it Softr token, and then add, as you see here, literally just follow the instructions. Just do all the scopes, read and write. And then after you checked off all of those, you can just press add access to all of the bases. So not just one workspace, or you can pick a specific one, it's up to you, but I usually like to just put all of it. And then now you can just copy the token, paste it in here, and then it allows you to connect to your Airtable account in a new way, since unfortunately the API key is no longer here. Another really cool update that's happened inside of Softr is the option to hide empty list details when the block record is not found. So essentially what that means is that in any of your different lists, you can filter it to something conditionally like logged in users client or like the assignee right here. So essentially anytime you're doing a filter that's conditional, you now can set at the bottom here so that you can hide the entire block if this doesn't apply to you. So for example, in this client portal, if I were to publish this after pressing hide entire block and then create a new user, that new user is not going to be connected to anything, right? So after I create this magic link for myself, as an example, and I go into this, you'll notice it's hidden here, right? Because this is only supposed to show up if when I'm logged in, the client is me or the assignee is me. But since I'm neither of those, the entire block is hidden and it doesn't show up anymore. Another really important update that's happened is that when adjusting our page URLs, things wouldn't persist. And that would be noticeable in headers and in buttons. So for example, you'll see that we have this button right here for open page for projects. If I were to change the project's URL here to something like projects test, change it to anything else, what would happen is that this button would break. Project still is connecting here, no problems whatsoever. Same here with the different header situations here. This project's page is still gonna persist. If I were to preview this and click on the project view as somebody who's logged in, it would still go to that project's page. Now, you may have noticed as I did that, I conveniently showed you another update that's really cool. Before, when you used to preview in Softr, it would be a completely different experience. You would log in as a non-logged in user. And then after that, what would happen is that you'd have to like manually do the login in the preview or publish the site and check it out in that format. But now you can preview it as a non-logged in user, or you can preview it as any of these logged in users that are available. So if I want to preview it as Charles, I totally can. So I can check it out like this and interact with the system completely from their point of view. And if I know what user group they're attached to, then I would know whether it's working properly for that person. Now, this is very useful for me as I'm the person who makes all the videos here, and the preview update just got a huge update, but it's also very good for you if you're trying to increase your understanding of the way that different people are seeing your Softr apps from their own user's perspective. I really like this update and recommend that you try using it out right now. Now, another really cool update is regarding customizing emails. So in the settings section here, we have email and SMS settings. So if we go to the email SMS templates, you'll notice that we've made it very easy for you to personalize the transactional emails that are sent to your app users. So if I'm sending an email, like how I added myself as a user earlier in this video, you can change what the email says. You can change what order it's in. And if you need to send a test email, you can do so. And you also, after making any of the changes, so just as a test, Thank you so much for joining. I can press save. Then you'll see right here, this is what it says. Now I can send this test email to myself. As you can see right here, this is the test email that was sent. That'll just send to your own email during the test process. And then if we don't really like it anymore, we can always revert it to default. And you'll see, just remove that section because that's all that I added. And you can do this exact same thing with the magic link as well. So very simple to do that. You can change the forgot password email, the verification email, and the verification SMS. All really simple stuff that just makes the entire feeling of using Softr a little bit more personal. And last but not least, a really cool update that's come to our charts is that if we go into this right here and we preview as a user like Lucy, you can say I can search there. You'll notice that this chart data is loading, but what's really cool is that we actually added a little tooltip right here that showcases the last time the data has been refreshed. You can see that on all the different charts we have. And the tooltip also states instant data refresh is only available in preview mode for testing purposes. It's not really available in the live app. So if I wanted to look at it in the actual app, we'd notice that it says your data has just been refreshed. And same here. So if it's been a while since it's been refreshed, it would state that. It would just let you know the last time it has been refreshed. For the preview and live modes, it's refreshing data every 15 minutes. And for edit mode, the sample data refreshes near real time. P.S. The preview that I showed actually does allow you to manually refresh it in preview mode so that you can conveniently test your apps out that way too. These are all amazing updates. I'm so excited for all the future things that we do have to offer here at Softr. If you have any questions about any of the updates, let us know in the comment section down below. And let us know your thoughts about this video and how to improve your skills using Softr even more.